the 13th chapter.
Solomon, that waves has calculated the traffic
on 75 and is directing me around traffic so that I can reach my destination in the desired time? Could it be, poor child, that OnStar is aware of Department of Transportation construction and is rerouting me so that I can avoid congested areas? Could it be, Tammy? Could it be that Google Maps is aware that Joshua's birthday wish is going to have a 5K run and they're rerouting me so that I'm not pinned down on a narrow, blocked off street? Beloved, all I know is that I have to rely on the GPS unit, and somehow it has access to up-to-date information, Brother Hubbard, that not only assists me in driving, but relieves the stress of being stuck in bumper-to-bumper traffic. Do I have a witness out there? I'm speaking to someone today who is experiencing God's divine planning for their life, and God has taken it upon God's self to detour you from the path that you're on towards your destiny. You know what God has called you to be, but God has taken you on an unusual and surreptitious route to get there. Look at your neighbor right now. Say, neighbor, God is divinely planning my route. Our unit, our selected portion of the sacred text for examination, is housed in the book of Exodus. The ebb and flow of this priestly post-exilic document is redemption through God's power, righteousness through God's holiness, and restoration through God's grace. In fact, this document highlights the themes of liberation, law, covenant, and presence. The text indicates that Pharaoh had let the people go. Pardon me while I pause right now to give God praise for release. Somebody say, for release. I'm not selfish, Pocha, so you can join with me if you like. God, dear Pocha, just want to thank you for the release that you've caused in our lives. God, you've released us from depression. You released us from anxiety. You released us from trauma. You released us from craziness. You released us from negativity. You released us from sexism. You released us from misogyny. You released us from oppression. You released us from racism. You released us from the grip of the enemy. Somebody ought to look at their neighbor right now and tell their neighbor, you are set free. Look at them again and tell them, you're no longer bound. Do I have anybody in here that you're no longer bound? You're free from every addiction in your life. You're free from stupidity. You're free from abuse. You're free from sin. You're free from bad habits. Perhaps that is why the gospel writer of John chapter 8 verse 36 teaches us, if the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall, do I have a witness in here, be free indeed. The text indicates that God did not plot a route that was direct and nearer to their destination, but that God detoured them using a route through the wilderness. The text indicates that God had a conversation with God's self. The text indicates that God said, Dr. Hubbard, if the people face war, they may change their minds and return to Egypt. The text indicates in the Hebrew that the Israelites left Egypt unprepared to fight, although they were in fighting formation. My job is to ask where God is in the text. My theological response is that God is trying to get you ready for the challenges of your destiny. Repeat after me. God is getting me ready for the challenges of my destiny. Oh, beloved, God must divinely detour you because you are not equipped to handle the challenges of your destiny. Look at your neighbor. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, you will have to fight for your destiny. Do I have a witness out there? Get into where God called you to be is not easy, and the route you want to travel will expose your vulnerabilities. Look at your neighbor again. Say, neighbor, you may not be ready for what you want. Did you hear what I said? Did you hear what I said? You may not be ready for what you've been praying for. You may not be ready for what you've been fasting for. God may not be ready for you to face war yet, because war will reveal your vulnerabilities. Come and sit with me and let us learn together what the text teaches us. Let us try to answer, why did God not want them to face war? Y'all ready to get on the train? Could it be, James Xavier, war would have revealed the Israelites' lack of development? Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, oh neighbor, are you developed for your journey? Hallelujah. Why would war, Dr. Amica, discourage them? Could it be that war would have revealed their lack of development? When we are faced with the challenges of our destiny, our lack of development may be disclosed. It takes a developed person to face war. It takes a developed person to face adversity. It takes a developed person to face the trials and tribulations of life. Beloved, had they gone the route through the territory of the Philistines, they would have certainly faced a fight to get to their destiny. The text teaches us that God wanted to develop them. They needed to grow up. They needed to grow in God. They needed to grow in grace. They needed to grow in faith. Beloved, I see something else hidden here in the text. Apparently, God did not call them to fight the Philistines yet. Did y'all hear what I said? Look at your neighbor right now and say to your neighbor, there are some enemies that God has not called you to fight. You better catch it. You better catch it. There are some battles that God has not called you to fight. You may not be developed enough to fight this fight. Therefore, God divinely detoured you, detoured them to avoid a losing fight with the Philistines. I see something else. I see something else. God knew that they weren't ready to lose. Did you hear what I'm saying? Catch it now. God knew that you're not ready to lose. Did you hear what I said? Either you're losing because you're fighting a fight that you have not been called to fight, or God has developed you enough that you will be able to rebound from the loss. Do you hear what I'm saying? I'm speaking to someone who is losing because you're in something God has not called you to engage in. My advice to you is to stand still and see what direction God wants to lead you. For the other person that God has developed and you are losing, just go ahead and put a smile on your face, put a praise in your belly, because guess what? You are the comeback kid. Look at your neighbor right now and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, I'm ready for a bounce back. Do I have any bounce back believers in here that you're ready for a comeback? You're ready for a turnaround. You're ready to bounce back. The devil tried to steal your joy, Why, James? Why was war a discouragement? Could it be? Could it be, James, that war would have revealed their lack of preparedness? Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, oh neighbor, are you prepared for your destiny? Check it out. Why would war discourage them? Could it be that war would have revealed their lack of preparedness? I invite you to do a close read, Susan, of the text. It appears that God wasn't concerned with who was behind or pursuing them as much as God was concerned about the hostile forces along the route. Are you prepared for your destiny? Are you prepared for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit? Are you prepared to walk on water? Are you prepared to bring mountains out of your way? Are you prepared to take on the challenges of your destiny? Are you emotionally prepared to handle your destiny? Beloved, your emotional makeup affects God's possibilities. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, oh neighbor, your emotional makeup affects God's possibilities. Baby, God is planning not to fail. You need to understand that. Whatever is going on right now, God has a plan, but God is planning not to fail. But your lack of preparedness will cause God to fail. I see something in the text, Mother Billingsley. God didn't call them to defeat the Philistines. God called them out of Egypt. I wish I had a witness here. God may not have called you. God may not have called us to defeat President Trump. But God is calling us out of dependence of our government. Do I have a witness there? Child of God. Stop trying to defeat things when God has called you out of things. Stop trying to stay in things that God has not prepared you to be in. Stop trying to fix stuff that God has never put on your plate. God has called you out of Egypt. Had God already prepared and planned for Pharaoh, but God had not prepared their faith for the Philistines. Don't put your hands on stuff that God has not prepared you to handle. Repeat these words after me. Don't put your hands on stuff that God has not prepared you to handle. Oh, thank you, West Angeles Church of God in Christ, for bringing to our listening ears. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true. And with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you. Do I have anybody? You're ready for God to prepare you, for God to mold you, for God to shape you. You want to lift your hands to heaven and say, Lord, fill my cup till it overflows. Why, James? Why did war discourage them? Could it be their lack of determination? Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, oh neighbor, are you determined to walk in the favor of God? Why would war discourage them? Could it be that war would have revealed their lack of determination? Apparently, God was concerned that the people might change their minds. It forced them to battle. God's leading is not independent of human involvement. How so, Pastor? This is why. Because, Sister Horton, had they lost to the Philistines, they would have gone back to what they knew. Child of God, I drove into work to tell you that we people look for a justification to give up. Weak people look for any excuse to cut and run. Weak people look for any justification to quit. Weak people have a limited perspective. Come on, Dale Bryant, help me with this exercise. She said, don't mistake familiar for freedom. Some cycles within us need to be broken. So look at your neighbor right now and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, it's time to break the cycle. Put a smile on your face and tell them again, it's time to break the cycle, because I invite you to a liberated destiny. I take apostolic authority. this day with you. The altar is open.